Good morning, students. Today we will start chapter 15, statistics. This is the chapter which is database chapter. Here introduction of the chapter is just we have to read. We know that statistics deal with data collected for specific purposes. We can make decision about the data by analyzing and interpreting it. In earlier classes, we have studied methods of representing data graphically and in tabular form. This representation reveals certain silent features or characteristics of the data. We have also studied the methods of finding a representative value for the given data. This value is called the measures of central tendency. Recall that is mean, median, and mod. Mean, median, and mod. These we have studied in the earlier classes. Mean, median, mod are three measures of the central tendency. A measure of the central tendency gives us a rough idea where data obtains, data points are centered, but in order to make better interpretation from the data, we should also have an idea how the data are scattered or how much they are bunched around a measure of central tendency. Here one example is given. Let's see the example. Here's example of two batsmen and score of the batsman is given. Batsman A 30, 91, 0, 64, 42, 80, 35 and 117 and 71. Same as data of B is given to you. Now when you calculate mean and median of this data, then you will get the batsman A and batsman B both are having same mean and same median. Now how to analyze which one data is better than the previous one? So for that you have to plot the values of scores which are obtained by batsman first or batsman second. Let's see. Here is the data. Batsman A, on a number line, we just plotted the values which are given for the batsman A. Zero, like this, these values. And for the batsman B, the values are plotted here. Now we can see here, the values or scores obtained by batsman A are more scattered than the batsman B scored. The values of batsman B are very near to center part. But in the case of batsman A, the data is scattered from 0 to 120. Now you can read the paragraph here written. We find, here we have to, yes. We find that the mean and median of the runs scored by both the batsmen A and B are same 53. Can we say that the performance of the two players is same? Clearly, no. Because of the variability in the scores of batsman A is from 0 to 117. You can see here, 0 to 117. Whereas the range of the runs scored by batsman B is from 46 to 60. In between 46 and 60. Let us now plot the graph here. The graph is plotted. Now we can see and we can observe from this graph, we can see that the dots corresponding to batsman B are close to each other and are clustering around the measures of central tendency, whether it is mean or median. While those corresponding to batsman A are scattered or more spread out. What is the meaning of this? Now you can take the example of two sections of class 11th. Suppose in evaluation 2 or half yearly evaluation, suppose section B scored from 0 to 20, but section A scored from 10 to 20. Which section is better? And average, suppose both are having average X. maybe in the section B, maximum students are getting 0, 1, 2, 3, and then a few are getting 20, 19, 20, 19, 20, 19, and average comes out X. But in the case of A, if average is X, it means very near to X, all numbers are lying. Maybe 15, 16, 14, 15, 16. Nobody have zero value. Nobody have less than 10 value. It means which section is better? Both are having average same, but section A is better than section B because nobody is scoring 0 or less than 10 in the section A. That's why A is a better one section. But how you got it? By plotting the points or plotting the values or scored by the students. Same is here in the batsman A and batsman B. Batsman B is performing better than the performing batsman A. Okay. Now here in this chapter, we will study measures of the dispersion. In this measures of dispersion, we will discuss about range. Quartile deviation is not in our syllabus. Mean deviation and standard deviation. One thing more, that is variance. Variance we will study. Now these four topics we will study in this chapter. Today we will discuss all these topics, all these four topics, and you will do questions of exercise. I'm discussing all the types of questions related to range, mean deviation, variance and standard deviation. First is range. Range we have studied in the class 10th also. Range means you have to know about the minimum observation and maximum observation. Minimum and maximum, the difference of maximum and minimum is known as the range. This is the definition of range. Range of a series is equal to maximum value minus minimum value. This is written here. Now mean deviation. Deviation means what? Deviation means what is the change in the observation with respect to the given mean or with respect to the given median. Here is the mean deviation first we will study. After that we will study median deviation. In the case of mean deviation, we will find mean first, then deviation corresponding to the mean. In the case of median, we will just first find out median and then we will find out deviation about the median. Now we have studied how to calculate mean and median in the previous classes. Even then we have done in the previous classes, but along with the questions we will discuss the previous part also. Here it is written one specific explanation which you have to know. Recall that the definition of an observation X from a fixed value A is a difference from is X minus A. In order to find the dispersion of the value of X from a central value A, we find the deviation about A. An absolute measure of the dispersion is the mean of these deviations. To find the mean, we must obtain the sum of the deviations, but we know that a measure of central tendency lies between the maximum and minimum values, the set of the observations. Whatever is given in the observations, always central tendency will lie between the maximum and minimum value. Therefore, some of the deviations will be negative and some of are positive. The sum of the deviation may vanish. What the paragraph is saying here, one thing you have to know, if observation is X1, X2, X3, suppose X4, and mean is X, this is mean. When I want to know what is the deviation between the observation and the mean, then I have to subtract first observation minus mean. I have to calculate it this. X2 minus mean. So let's write down mean, sign is bar, should be here in the, suppose. And X3 minus mean. X4 minus mean. When I add these all deviations, always you are getting zero. Sum of the divisions is always equal to zero. It is written, you can see here, sum of the divisions always equal to zero. Then how to find out the division when it is always zero? Then what if we have to do not to make the sum of divisions zero? We have two methods to avoid this zero. The first one is, as we have studied here, some observations gives you negative difference or some will give you positive. It means what? Minus 2, 2, minus 1, 1, any value you can get. Sometimes positive or sometimes negative. And after adding, you are getting 0. One thing we can do, that is for the mean deviation, we can take the mod of the difference. Whatever mod you will get, you have to take the mod of that. Then it means what? Statement becomes positive. It means you will get a number, not a zero. Minus 2 plus 2, 0. Minus 1, 1, 0. But when I take mod of these, it means answer will be 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1, 5 plus 1, 6. Answer will be 6. That is not equal to 0. So what we will do? We will make the mod of the given difference. Then we will get the mean deviation. So here is a formula. What is the formula to get the mean deviation about the mean and median? Here is a formula which we have to learn. This is a process which I have told you. Now here is a formula which you have to learn for the grouped or ungrouped data. First is for the ungrouped data. Mean deviation about mean, that is summation of xi minus a mod divided by n. And second, when the ungrouped data is not given, group data is given to you. In case mean deviation about mean, x bar means mean, 1 upon n summation of xi minus x bar, where x bar is a mean. And mean deviation about median, capital M means median. Then the mean is replaced by median. So xi minus mean is replaced by xi minus median. This is a formula, mean deviation about median, mean deviation about mean. And for the ungrouped data, that is mean deviation about a means any mean. These formulae you have to learn. For the discrete classes, then formula will be changed, which we'll study after that. Let's do few questions. Let's see. Example number one, find the mean deviation about the mean for the given data. This data is this one. If you want mean deviation about mean, it means you have to calculate mean first. How to calculate the mean of the ungrouped data? Add the observation divided by number of observation, you will get mean, that is 9. Now next step, get the difference of the observation about the mean. 6 minus 9, 7 minus 9, third observation is 10 minus 9, 12 minus 9, and so on, difference. After that, next step, if we don't take mod, then the summation of division of observation becomes zero. So avoid to zero, it means we have to take the mod of each difference. Mod of each difference, here it is written mod. Now add them, summation means addition of these mean deviations. We are adding, add these. You are getting this is xi minus x bar mod. This is this one. Submission means add these observations. You are getting addition, that is 22. And number of observations are 8 divided by 8. So answer will be 2.75. If it is again it is mean, then you can do the question. same example is here, second example. Come to the third example about the median. Now here is find the mean deviation about median. It means you have to first find out median. Now you must know how to find out the median of the ungrouped data. First of all, arrange the data in ascending order. Then count the observations. Count the observations. Number of observations are 11. You can't divide 11 by 2. So add 1. N plus 1 by 2. 2th observation will be the median. 6th observation. Count 6 observation. You will get 9. 9 is the median. Now same procedure will be there as we did in a example number 1. Xi minus median. Now here median is 9. And take the mod of the difference. Wherever you get negative sign, it becomes positive when you take the mod. 3 minus 9, this is 6, 6, 5, 4, and these are the observation. Add these observations and divide it by number of observations. That are, those are 11. So answer will be 5.27. Now, for the group data, what to do? As you know, how to calculate the mean of the group data? Summation of Fi, Xi divided by summation of Fi. And you know how to get the median also. But the formula to calculate mean deviation of the discrete data is this one. In the previous ungrouped data, observations are given to you. Now here, Fi and Xi are given to you. So you have to multiply it by frequency to the mod of Xi minus mean, or in the case of median, Xi minus mean. This is important. Summation of Fi into mod of Xi minus mean divided by summation of Fi. Or sometimes we will write this is capital N. Now let's do the question examples. In the case of median, I have told you, you have to put here capital N. Now do the example number 4. Now find the mean deviation about mean. As you have studied, you can calculate the mean when Xi and Fi are given. The way to calculate mean is summation of Fi Xi divided by summation of Fi. I just want to say you have studied 3 formulae of getting mean in the class 10th. First is direct method, which I am telling you here. This is a direct method. And 2 methods. There is assumed mean method. And third one you have studied, that is the shortcut method. You can adopt any of these to calculate the mean. Which you think is easier one, then you can choose that one. Maybe direct, maximum time students opt direct method because it's easy to find out summation of Fi Xi divided by summation of Fi. This is a way which maximum student opted to get the mean. But you can choose any of these methods. Okay. Now example number 4, mean is you have to find out. So here direct method is used, assumed method is also used, shortcut method is used. All 3 methods are used and given examples in the in this exercise. You can observe example number 4 now. Here, summation of Fi Xi calculated 300 and divided by 40. Here you will get mean will be equal to 7.5. Here is the mean we have calculated. Now mean deviation. For mean deviation, you have to do what? You have to get the difference and take the mod. Xi minus mean. Xi means 2 minus, what is the mean? That is 7.5. 2 minus 7.5. That is minus 5.5 and take mod, that is 5.5. Simplify it, all these. Add them. Sorry. Here is a frequency is given. Multiply by frequency. Then 2 into 5.5, 8 into 2.5. We are getting these values. And add these values now. And divided by summation of Fi, that is 40. Yes. Yes, here is a. This is a mean deviation about mean. and that is 92 divided by 40, that is 2.3. This is the mean deviation about mean. Now in the next example, we will study mean deviation about median. As you already know how to get the median, now let's see the procedure to get the median. Then about median, you have to apply the formula. In the case of median, you have to find out the cumulative frequency first. Cumulative frequency means first, 3 as it is, 3 plus 4, 7, 7 plus 5, 12, 12 plus 2, 14, 14 plus 4, 18, 18 plus 5, 23, 25 plus 4, these are added. You are getting cumulative frequency. And first is as it is. I think this is the way you have studied earlier in earlier classes. Now, this is 30. Now, what is the median? Median means 30 is divided by 2, you are getting 15. And this is an even number. So, 15th term and 16th observation. Here, 15th observation will be corresponding to the cube. 3, 7, 12, 14, 15 will come in this addition. So, corresponding to this, this is 13. If I am taking 15th and 16th, then I am getting again 13. Up to 18, this is the observation corresponding to the 13, 15, 16, 17 and 18 to all. So, what 13 plus 13 divided by 2 and the median will be equal to 13. Let's see. Yes, median is equal to 13. Now, you have to calculate what is the mean deviation about median. It means xi minus median mod of xi minus median. 10, 7, 4, 1, 0, 2, 8 and 9. Now you can calculate difference and its mod. Difference and its mod. And fi is multiplied by this mod value. You are getting multiplication of these. You are getting 30, 28, 20, 2, 0, 10 and 32, 27. Now summation of these means add them. Add all these values. What are you getting? That is 149. And divided by summation of fi, that is 30. 149 divided by 30, you are getting 4.97. This is the way to get the mean deviation about median. Now for the continuous frequency distribution, how to get the median and mean? All are here. Formulae which we are using, you can apply all these formulae and do all the questions in your notebook, then only you can get the idea how to do the questions. Now for the continuous frequency distribution, what is the meaning of continuous distribution? It means class intervals are given to you. In the case of continuous frequency distribution, if class intervals are given, then how to find out the xi? As we know that the sum of the lower and upper limit divided by 2, you will get the xi. And frequency will be given to you. Let's see. Yes, class intervals are given. How to get the xi? Midpoint. It means sum of lower and upper limit divided by 2. This is 15. This is 25. If you get fi and xi, then you can get mean by using what the formula? Summation of fi xi divided by summation of fi. This will give you mean. Here is the procedure to get. Mean will be equal to 45 and median will be equal to what? By using the formula, because frequencies are given, fi into mod of xi minus mean, 1 upon 40 into 400, that is 10. Now you know the formula of median when class intervals are given. I think you can apply that formula. I just to show you, this is a formula to get the here is the way. Okay, you can do the question by using direct method. Here the method is given to get the mean deviation. For mean, it is given only assume mean method is given here. You can apply direct method and assume mean method. This is your choice. Now next one may be the way to get the median when the class intervals are given to you. This is a formula which you have studied in a class 10th. Lower limit of the median class, sum of the frequency n, and see the commutative frequency of the previous median class. H is what? Difference of the class intervals. F is the frequency of the median class. This formula you have applied in the class 10th, and when the class intervals are given to you, in that case you have to find out the median by using this formula. Here is one example which is according to this formula. Here is example number 7. In this example number 7, you will apply the formula to get the median. That is, this formula median is equal to L plus N by 2 minus C upon F into H. Same formula which you have used in the class 10. When you get the median, then you can use that median for what? To calculate the mean deviation about the median. Same formula you have to apply, which we have done in our previous examples. Now you have to do exercise 15.1. Now we will discuss further concepts, variance and standard deviation also in the same video, but you will do in two or three days. Variance and standard deviation. As I have told you, in the case of mean deviation, to make the statement positive, so that the mean deviation shouldn't equal to zero, sum of the mean deviation shouldn't equal to zero. For that, you have taken the absolute value. In the case of variance, second method we have used. As I told you, in the case of mean deviation, about mean or about median, what you did? We did like this. Xi minus x bar mod. This is a way to make the statement positive. Now, second way to make the statement positive is what? Take the square of that statement. If minus 3 mod is 3, as we solve this minus 3 square, again I am getting what? 9. Number positive. It means there are two ways to make the statement positive. First way, to take the mod, which we have done in the case of mean deviation. When we square the statement, again the statement becomes positive. This case we will discuss in the case of variance. When we square the statement, then the method which is known as the variance, and variance is known as sigma square. Sigma square is representing variance. 1 upon n summation of I is equal to 1 to n xi minus x bar whole square. It means where you are doing mod, here you are doing the square of the difference of the deviation. Now let's see how to do the questions. If you want standard deviation, I want to just, here is the next way. Yes. When you want standard deviation, just you have to take the square root of the variance. Standard deviation is equal to square root of the variance. This is the formula you have to learn. Here are a few more formula to find out the standard deviation. Shortcut formulas are there, which we will study in the examples. But if you don't know the shortcut, then you can apply this formula directly, get the variance and take the square root of the variance, you will get the standard deviation. Let's see a few examples. Here's the first example. Find the variance of these given data observations. What do you have to do? You have to do the question like this. The given data, we can form the following. The mean is calculated by step deviation method. Here the method which is used to get the mean is step deviation method, but you can do by using direct method. What is the mean? Summation of fi xi divided by summation of fi. You can use that method. Here I've told you so many times, mean can be calculated by direct method, which is easier one to do the question. Same mean you will get, that is 15. What you will do? Now take the difference of the, in the table, let's see. Take the difference of the observation and the mean, and square it. Here square sign should be there. Minus 9 square 81, minus 7 square 49. In the previous mean deviation case, you are just taking mod. Here I am squaring the statement. Square the statement, add them, and divide it by number of observations. Here is the formula. Add them, divide by number of observations, you are getting 33. But I have told you, standard deviation is the square root of variance. Square root of 33, find out the square root, then you will get the 5.74. This is the standard deviation. Now, in the case of shortcut, you will use the formula is, sometimes you use standard deviation formula, this one. When the frequency is given, in the case of frequencies, you will use this formula to get the standard deviation. If you want, this is a way to get, I think you have to apply now the formulas. Next formula which you have to apply, that is this one formula. This is a formula which you have to apply to get the standard deviation. This is a shortcut method to get the mean deviation. What is written here? I have just told you, 1 upon n, n means sum of observations. N means sum of sum of frequencies. Summation of, I will write down summation of fi. This is summation of fi. Here is fi xi square. First you have to calculate xi square, then multiply by frequency to xi square and add them. You will get this statement. And what is this? This is the summation of fi xi square. Multiply the fi and xi and square the statements and then add them. Here is written, I will just show you in the table. They say that is n, 50 is n, xi is the midpoint of the class intervals. Multiplying fi xi, you are getting this one. Xi minus x bar whole square and fi into xi minus x bar whole square, same. If frequencies are given, in the case of mean deviation, we write like this. In the case of variance, this will be square. This is the difference. And square them, add them, and apply the formula. Is the formula. Yes, you can put the values. And standard deviation is square root of the variance, 14.18. Now next, if class interval is not given and xi, fi are given, then you can apply the formula, this one. It is written here, same formula is there. You can do the question. In the case of class interval, you have to find out the midpoint of the class intervals, then you will get the xi. If xi is directly given, it means half work is done for you. Xi is given to you. Now you can apply the formula. The shortcut method to get the but I think you have to apply only direct methods to mean for variance and for standard deviation. You can apply this shortcut method, but this is a shortcut method, but calculation is, calculation becomes easier, but length of the question becomes longer. So I think it's easier to find out the mean variance and standard deviation by the simple method. Do these questions of getting mean deviation, variance and standard deviation. These are the topics which are in your syllabus in this chapter, statistics. I hope you can do the exercises, first and second exercise both. In the first exercise, you have to do the questions of mean deviation. In the second exercise, you have to do the questions of variance and standard deviation. It means you have to do exercise 15.1, 15.2. These two exercises are in your syllabus. Do these exercises. This question 2 is important question. Try this question. Otherwise, I will discuss in the next video, this question number 2. I hope you can do the questions. Thank you. Have a nice day.